Hi, and in today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make this really quick and simple letterhead in Word. So the first thing you need to do is to decide if you're going to put all of your graphics into your headers and footers. If you do this, they will repeat on each page, but you don't have to. You can also just put them into the page itself. So if I double click at the top here, you can see I'm now in the headers and footers. So let's go to Insert, Picture, click on the drop down, Picture from File. Now I'm going to insert my logo. You'll have your own logo. So I'm going to select my image here and click Insert. And then with everything that's inserted into Word, generally you can't move it. So you have to select it, go to Picture Format, go to Wrap Text, click on the drop down. You can select from any of these, but I generally select in front of text because it generally works with everything. Now don't be fooled by this blue line. You don't have to put everything in your headers and footers above that line or below that line. In headers and footers, you can put anything anywhere on your page and it will still appear in your headers and footers. So I'm just going to reduce the size of this logo and pop it about there. Next, go to Insert, Shapes, click on the drop down and select the square and then just click and drag. And move this over to about here, and then I'm going to customize it with the colors and then copy and paste it. So select it, go to Shape Format, go to Shape Outline, click on the drop down, and I'm going to select No Outline. Each shape will come with an outline. It's very thin and narrow, you can't really see it, but if you zoom in, you'll be able to see it. I'm just going to get rid of that. Now I'm going to go to Shape Format and along to Format Pane. Over in Format Pane, I'm going to choose the bucket icon here, go to Fill, click on the drop down, and I'm going to scroll down to Gradient Fill. Now in Gradient Fill here, you'll see a slider with two boxes that look like little houses. If you click on these boxes, you can change the color, so select it, go to Color, click on the drop down, and select from a color of your choice. If you don't see the color of your choice, click More Colors. You've got the color wheel here, and you've also got the brightness and darken slider here as well. The color you select will come up in this box here. Once you're happy, you just click OK. Now, as you can see, these colors I've selected from my logo, and that will give my whole look some cohesion. And in addition, to make sure that your logo goes left to right, choose type. You can choose linear, which I've chosen here, and the direction. Click on the drop down. Just move this over so you can see it. I've selected this one here, but you can select any of these options. It's all very much a personal choice. So once we've done that, if you want to deselect anything in your headers and footers, if you click in the main body, it won't work. You have to click in the headers and footers to deselect anything. So I'm happy with that. So now I'm going to copy and paste it. So select it. I'm going to hold down my Alt or Option key, click, and then just drag another one of those. The other option is, if you select one, press Command or Control and the C key, deselect it, and then Command or Control V, and that will also copy and paste another one of those elements. I'm going to pop this one down at the bottom here, and then this one I'm going to put next to it. To make sure these are both aligned, I'm going to select this one, hold down my Command or Control key and click on this one. You can see they're both now selected. Go to Shape Format, go to Align, click on the drop down and select Align to Top. And those will be perfectly lined up. So to keep them as one element, I'm going to group them together. So again, select them both, go to Shape Format, Group, click on the drop down and select Group. And now that's one element and you can move it around to suit your taste. So as you can see, we've got the main body of our letterhead in. So now we need to put the body of our letter in here. Now there's two ways you can do this. If I double click in the center of my page, you'll see I'm now in the main body and I can actually just type as I would normally. Now you see everything is grayed out in the headers and footers, but that's fine because that just tells you all of those elements are not in the main body, but they are in the headers and footers. Now if you want to send this, obviously if you send it as a PDF file, it'll be absolutely perfect. All the colors will be vibrant and nothing will be grayed out. So the next problem you've got is the cursor here. Now you can hit the return key, which is fine. Alternatively, let's just go back up. You can use the rulers here and the margins. So if you can't see your rulers, go to View, Ruler, make sure that's checked. Hover the cursor between the gray and white section, click, and then you can pull that all the way down to where you want your cursor to begin. And as you can see, the cursor's now moved. So on every single page now, if you wanted to insert another page, let's just go into page break, you'll see that your cursor will appear in the right place on each page. So let's just go back. Now, personally, if I'm only writing a single page letter, I will actually only put all of my text into a text box. So go to Insert, Text Box, click on the drop down and select Draw Text Box, and click and drag out a text box. Don't worry about the size at the moment. Then I'm going to grab some text, just copy and paste it in. I'm sure you don't want to see me typing. I'm just going to narrow that slightly. This is the great thing about using a text box, is it's really flexible. You can move the text anywhere you like. If you don't like the margins, you can make them bigger or smaller. Now, to ensure this is perfectly lined up, select it, go to Shape Format, Align, Align to Center. Now, if I deselect this text box, you can see we've got a black border around the outside, but we've also got a white fill color. I'm going to get rid of both of those, so select it, go to Shape Format, go to Shape Outline, click on the drop down and select No Outline, go to Shape Fill, click on the drop down and select No Fill. Now I'm going to put in the signature block and also the contact information. Now, instead of having to take out the borders and the background color like we've just done, I'm just going to simply copy and paste this text box. So I've selected it. Make sure your cursor is not inside the text box because it won't work. So deselect, reselect it. You can see my cursor's not inside, and then hold down the Alt or Option key, click and drag. Then I'm simply going to click inside, click and drag across all of my text, and then just insert my new text. Pop this down at the bottom here so we can see it. To make sure this is perfectly lined up, select this box, hold down your Command or Control key, select this box, go to Shape Format, go to Align, Align to Left. Now that's all lined up. Again, we can borrow this box. So select it, Alt or Option key, click and drag. And then this time I'm going to select the text, go to the Home tab, go to this icon here, which is Right Align or Align to Right. And then I'm going to simply put my text in. Okay, once you're happy with that, we can select this box. Again, holding down the Command or Control key, go to Shape Format, Align, Align to Right, making sure that's all lined up. Now you can see my text in here is justified. What I mean by that is all the text forms a square. So if I select all the text, go to the Home tab, and then go to this icon here, you see Left Aligned, Center, Right Align, and Justify. And Justify will make sure the text looks like a neat box. Once you're happy with all of this, then select it, hold down the Command or Control key, select this box and this box, go to Shape Format, go to Groups, click on the drop down and select Group. And now all of this is one element. And again, you can move all this round, you can change the dimensions, and you can make it look exactly how you want. So select it, go to Shape Format, Align, Align to Center, which will ensure it's perfectly lined up. Once you're done, take a careful look at your design. Make sure there aren't too many gaps that you don't like. I feel like this is too close to the top of the page, so I'm going to double click at the top here into my headers and footers. Just going to move this down slightly, move this one down, maybe a little bit more. Double click into the main body of it, and I think that looks perfect. So if you now want to save this as a PDF, go to File, Save As. You can go to the bottom here, it says File Format, click on the drop down and save as a PDF. So you can do that, or you can save this as a template. So go to File, Save as Template, and then make sure that this is selected here, Templates. And also at the bottom here, File Format, Microsoft Word Template. What that means is that you can open up the Word software, and in your templates will be this design. And when you use it, you will be asked to save it as a new document each time, so you won't overwrite the original. And then just click Save. So here is the PDF of the letter, and you can see it all looks absolutely perfect. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please like and subscribe, and have a great day.